Hello, Eve, and happy birthday. Wow, I had no idea. I didn't realize your birthday was actually it's such a significant time of the year. It's the beginning of the new Jewish year. We just came out of the 7th year Shemitah. We're entering into the year of Jubilee right now, and the whole feast of Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, Day of Atonement. Wow. Wow. God bless you. I love you, Eve, and I am so excited for you to just come into the fullness and the healing and the authority and the freedom in Jesus' name. So I'll go ahead and pray for you. Heavenly Father, thank you that you've got your hand on this precious woman of God. Lord, it grieves us that we could come together and know each other and share in your truth and love for one another, but yet all these miles are between us, and there's it just seems like the people that we find are so far away. So Father, that's my first prayer for you, for your daughter. I ask you to give her somebody close by within her physical location where she can come into solemn assembly, somebody to pray with and to exhort, somebody who will exhort her in the things of God, somebody to turn to, not in place of you, Lord, but in surrounding in with you at their center, Father. Or please bless her with somebody, Lord, that she can work with in you. And Lord, I just thank you that although the darkness has had a heyday and caused all these troubles, you are still on the throne and you are in charge of Eve's life. You know every detail that is going on and you are not pleased, but there are reasons and you know of them, Father God. And the darkness is exactly what you have rescued us from. Father, Colossians 1:13 says that you have rescued us from the dominion of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of your holy Son. Father God, you know the day and the hour that Eve gave her life to you and said that you are her Lord and that she came into the saving knowledge of Jesus. She came under the power of the blood of Jesus that washed her away, that cut her off from the darkness. So Satan, what that means is that every power and minion from hell that has been at work and assigned to her since long before Christ, long before she was even born through the sins of the father and the generational curses and all of your of these systems of demons that have been appointed to work in her life, that have continued to work in her life since the day she was rescued from your dominion. You have been trespassing, though she hasn't understood how to come out of your illusion. The fact is, she is out of it. She is officially released from your dominion. You have no right in Jesus' name. I don't care where she is still yet not perfected in her mind and understanding of God and His Word. And we know that the ignorance, the Bible says that my people perish for lack of knowledge, and that there's always something we don't know, and you take advantage of it. That's the only reason you're getting away with anything right now. But her God is good and faithful and true, and He will finish His work in her. He finishes everything he starts, and he is for her. I declare that right now. So all of the deception and everything you've been getting away with right now, Father God is calling it out and saying, no, no more. The Lord rebuke you and your hold, your strongholds, and your interference with his will for her life, and your oppression, and your controlling her body. The Lord rebuke you in the name of Jesus, by the authority granted at the cross of Calvary, when that holy blood was shed and offered up as that sacrifice for Eve, which rescued her from your dominion, which she received. You are hereby put out in Jesus' name. I command you by that authority, go. Satan, take all of these powers that have been at work and cease and desist right now in Jesus' name. I command you to loose Evelyn right now in Jesus' holy name. Holy God, holy Lord, holy God, thank you. Thank you. Father, bless Evelyn now. Restore her mind, her body, her soul, and her spirit. Every deception, every confusion, Lord, undo it. Heal her. I call forth your healing power now to manifest. In Jesus' name, Father, give her the confidence of your word. Colossians 1:13 that says, she has been rescued from the dominion of darkness. This is a sure reality. Let it be her understanding now. Holy Spirit, breathe this divine understanding into her depths and core. Penetrate her where the fears and the faith in the darkness has prevailed. Father, your truth is manifest by our faith and by our believing. Help Eve's unbelief right now. Lord, she is like everybody else. We become confident in what we see, but you say, lean not on your own understanding. And that's what we do. Forgive us, Lord. Forgive her, Lord. This is just how we are, how we fail. But Lord, I join with her. I join with your truth. And I declare it. I decree it right now. It's over, Satan. You are exposed. And you are officially being addressed right now as a trespasser on holy ground, holy property, on a daughter of the Most High God. So take up your baggage, take up your workers, get out in Jesus' mighty name. And Father, restore her health and her life to what you destined before time. I call forth wherever she was supposed to be, had there never been any interference from darkness, I call forth that destiny, the destiny of the Holy One, the author of life, the Alpha and Omega, Jesus himself. I call forth the destiny of Christ, of Evelyn, to come forth right now, to be restored, and to come into place. Father God, heal her body, bring it into balance. I speak order over her body right now. I command every system, even you systems of the respiratory system, the hormonal system, all systems, I command you to stop adhering to what you have understood and the imbalance that you have been. Yes, I'm speaking to your body, Evelyn. Speaking to your mind. I'm speaking to your soul. I'm speaking to your heart, but I'm speaking to your body. Your body has only ever understood the darkness and the chaos and the imbalance and the deficiency and the struggle. So that's what it, since that's all it understands, it's what it expects. But I'm telling you, your mind and your body and your soul, to forget about what you've understood. Shake it off right now. What you have known is not your real reality. It's been the illusion that you've been in for decades. Now shake it off. Your real reality is freedom. Your real reality is whole health. Your real truth is well-being. The imbalance that you've understood, the fatigue and the pain that you've understood, has all been the darkness, which you know that, but it's an illusion, and it's not your reality anymore. It is not real. It's not allowed. The blood of Jesus is sufficient. It has addressed it. In the name of Jesus, it has been told to leave. And it will leave when you agree that it has no right and it's not allowed to be real. But it will act like it's real. And as long as you continue to accept and perceive that it should be real, it will continue to be real. It's not real. It only seems real. Now stand on the truth. You have been rescued from the dominion of darkness and transferred into the kingdom of God's dear Son. Your body is well in Jesus. Shake off the lies. Shake off the manifestation of the liar. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Now breathe on her, Holy Spirit. Fill her anew and afresh. Father, I ask that every system be brought into balance. Hormones be brought into balance. Everything that's deficient be built up. Everything that's out of control to be brought down to a normal, proper level. Everything be restored. I call forth the strength. Lord, I call forth stamina to be her understanding and her knowing, Lord. Give her the faith, Father, to lay hold of this truth. Don't let her believe the liar anymore. Help her, Father. Help her by your Spirit. Get out of the way, devil. Get out of the way. Spirit of God, reveal yourself and help her. Help her lay hold of this now in Jesus' name. And bless her, Lord. I pray that this year, Father, that you would you give her great revelation, more wisdom, Lord. Take her into the deep things of you, Lord. She has nothing on this earth but you. You are her hope. You are her glory. You are all that matters. Father, please give her great revelation and wisdom, divine understanding, Lord. Take her into your presence like never before. Show her how to be one with you like never before. Father, let your light shine and let the joy of the Lord be her strength. Hallelujah. I speak joy. Joy unspeakable. Oh, my sister, I love you, Evelyn. Oh, how wonderful the Lord is to us. How much he loves us. Blessed be his holy name. Thank you, Lord. Rise in my sister now. Fill her to overflowing. Hallelujah. I declare the will and the works and the destiny of God shall be done 100% fulfilled in this life, this precious life chosen and called out by the living God. Praise you, Lord. Thank you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.